Hi, this is Kurt Bennick with 4ConstructionPros.com. We're here at the 2020 Work Talk Show, and we're here with Jason Gies, Director of E-Mobility for Navistar, and we're standing in front of a unique new product, the MV Series, a battery electric vehicle.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so this is a fully battery electric EMV, we're calling it. It's a tech demonstrator at this point and a show vehicle. We're trying to give our customers a vision into what we're doing at Navistar and International Trucks on the electrification side of our business. So you'll see the unique hood here all the way through a fully battery electric powertrain and vehicle.
Do you have some early specs on what you expect this truck to do in terms of range and what you expect in terms of power outputs?
Yes, we do. So on the range, we're offering three different battery sizes. One roughly around 100 kilowatts, one roughly around 200 kilowatts, and one roughly around 300. With the base battery, we expect around 70 miles range. With the larger battery, we can get up above 200 miles range.
Okay, and we understand with fleets, it's more than just about product. It's also about how do you integrate battery electric vehicles into your fleet? How is Navistar addressing that issue?
Yeah, so we have a very large consultative approach that we're doing with this. We are talking to our customers from anything from charging to infrastructure to grants to funding for the vehicles, for grants for the charging, all the way through having the vehicles and how we deal with batteries, if there's issues with batteries, to end of life batteries, battery swapping if they start having range degradation down the road. We're focusing on all of those areas and informing our customers and teaching them how they can be successful in this type of space.
What are some of the most common questions you get from customers at this point about the battery electric vehicle and the MV series in particular?
How do I charge it is an extraordinarily common one. Mm-hmm. So we're working with customers hand in hand doing remote site surveys and helping them understand we can start small. Maybe it's a one AC level 2 charger, all the way up to what is it going to look like if I buy 50 of these vehicles? How am I going to deal with our power providers? How am I going to deal with parking these things and charging them overnight and the different charge times? So that's probably our biggest question. And I think second is, what is my range going to be and how does it operate in different climates? So through our consultative approach, we can do route planning with our customers. So we can say, on the coldest day, you're going to get X amount on this route. On the hottest day, we'll do the same. And then your median range will be about this too. So we can work through those types of details.
Okay, and it's kind of interesting because in the past, Navistar hasn't done a lot with alternate fuel, but yet you're looking very heavily at battery electric. What is it about battery electric that really gets to the heart of what Navistar sees the future in?
Right, well, at Navistar, as you can see, diesel's not going away in our world. But we see this as a piece of the future. There are very specific areas and markets and customers that today will be glad to take this type of vehicle. We don't see this as a long haul opportunity for us, but today we see this for sure in short haul regional delivery applications. The customers that drive under 150 miles could take and run today in their normal duty cycles.
Okay, and is this going to have your full suite, I imagine, of telematic solutions?
Yes. So we want to make sure we're giving our customers telematics on the batteries, on their range. Driver behavior is a huge one. So we want to make sure we have part of our team will be out training our drivers to make sure they understand regenerative braking. We want to give that same feedback through our telematics to the fleet operators. The other thing we'll be offering too is through our charging partners and some of our preferred charging vendors for the charging stations themselves, is telematics is it charging? How long is it going to take to charge? Should I fast charge it? Should I slow charge it? We can give that feedback to our fleet managers so they're comfortable when they lay down at night that all my trucks are charging and they can go out and do their jobs in the morning.
Okay, in terms of this is a initial prototype, we understand it's a test mule. Yep. What are we looking at in terms of time frames and guesstimates of when this might be available?
So Navistar as a whole, our group is the Next E-Mobility team. We're focusing on both school bus and medium duty trucks. We're launching school buses this year. We'll have them in customers' hands by the end of 2020. That same technology is going into our trucks, so we're doing the programs in parallel, and we'll be able to offer the EMV to select customers, and I'd say middle of 2021.
Okay. Well, Jason, we really appreciate you giving a rundown of the MV, and thanks a lot for all the information.
No problem.